Disclaimer: the following is a fan reading of several excerpts from the Revenge of the Sith novelization. All credit for this brilliant story goes to Matthew Stover. Shaak-Ti felt him coming before she could see him. The infra and ultrasound sensitive cavities in the tall, curving montrals to either side of her head gave her a sense analogous to touch. The texture of his approaching footsteps was ragged as old sacking. As he rounded the corridor to the landing deck door, his breathing felt like a pile of gravel, and his heartbeat was spiking like a Zabrak's head. He didn't look good either. He was deathly pale, even for a human, and his eyes were raw. "Anakin," she said warmly. Perhaps a friendly word was what he needed. She doubted he'd gotten any from Mace Windu. "Thank you for what you have done. The Jedi Order is in your debt. The whole galaxy as well." "Shaak-Ti, get out of my way." Shaky as he looked, there was nothing unsteady in his voice. It was deeper than she remembered, more mature, and it carried undertones of authority she had never heard before. And she was not blind to the fact that he had neglected to call her master. She put forth a hand, offering calming energies through the Force. "The temple is sealed, Anakin. The door is code-locked. And you're in the way of the pad." She stepped aside, allowing him to the pad. She had no reason to keep him here against his will. He punched the code hungrily. "If Palpatine retaliates," she said reasonably, "is not your place here to help with our defense?" "I'm the chosen one. My place is there." His breathing roughened, and he looked as if he was getting even sicker. "I have to be there. That's the prophecy, isn't it? I have to be there." "Anakin, why? The Masters are the best of the Order. What could you possibly do?" The door slid open. "I'm the chosen one," he repeated. "Prophecy can't be changed. I'll do." He looked at her with eyes that were dying, and a spasm of unbearable pain passed over his face. Shaak-Ti reached for him. He should be in the infirmary, not heading toward what might be a savage battle, but he lurched away from her hand. "I'll do what I'm supposed to do," he said, and sprinted into the night and the rain. The following is a transcript of an audio recording presented to the Galactic Senate on the afternoon of the First Empire Day. Identities of all speakers verified and confirmed by voice print analyses. Palpatine. "Why, Master Windu, what a pleasant surprise." Mace Windu. "Hardly a surprise, Chancellor, and it will be pleasant for neither of us." Palpatine. "I'm sorry. Master Fisto, hello. Master Kolar, greetings. I trust you are well. Master Tin. I see your horn has regrown. I'm very glad. What brings four Jedi Masters to my office at this hour?"
Mace Windu.
"We know who you are, what you are. We are here to take you into custody."
Palpatine.
"I beg your pardon? What I am? When last I checked, I was Supreme Chancellor of the Republic you have sworn to serve. I hope I misunderstand what you mean by custody, Master Windu. It smacks of treason."
Mace Windu.
"You're under arrest."
Palpatine.
"Really, Master Windu, you cannot be serious. On what charge?"
Mace Windu.
"You're a Sith Lord."
Palpatine.
"Am I? Even if true, that's hardly a crime. My philosophical outlook is a personal matter. In fact, the last time I read the Constitution anyway, we have strict laws against this type of persecution. So I ask again, what is my alleged crime? How do you expect to justify your mutiny before the Senate? Or do you intend to arrest the Senate as well?
Mace Windu.
We're not here to argue with you.
Palpatine.
No. You're here to imprison me without trial, without even the pretense of legality. So, this is the plan. At last, the Jedi are taking over the Republic.
Mace Windu.
Come with us, now.
Palpatine.
I shall do no such thing. If you intend to murder me, you can do it right here.
Mace Windu.
Don't try to resist.
Sounds that have been identified by frequency resonances to be the ignition of several lightsabers. Palpatine.
Resist? How could I possibly resist? This is murder, you Jedi traitors! How could I be any threat to you? Master Tin, you're the telepath. What am I thinking right now?
Sounds of scuffle. Kit Fisto.
Saisi.
Agen Kolar. Garbled. Possibly, it doesn't hurt. Sounds of scuffle. Palpatine.
Help! Help! Security! Someone! Help me! Murder! Treason!
Recording ends.
A fountain of amethyst energy burst from Mace Windu's fist. Don't try to resist. The song of his blade was echoed by green fire from the hands of Kit Fisto, Agen Kolar, and Saisi Tin. Kolar and Tin closed on Palpatine, blocking the path to the door. Shadows dripped and oozed color, weaving and coiling up the office walls, slipping over chairs, spreading along the floor. Resist! How could I possibly resist? Still seated at the desk, Palpatine shook an empty fist helplessly, the perfect image of a tired, frightened old man. This is murder, you Jedi traitors! How could I be any threat to you? He turned desperately to Saisi Tin. Master Tin, you're the telepath. What am I thinking right now? Tin frowned and cocked his head. His blade dipped. A smear of red, flashing darkness hurled from behind the desk. Saisi Tin's head bounced when it hit the floor. Smoke curled from the neck, and from the twin stumps of the horns, severed just below the chin. Kit Fisto gasped, "Saisi!" The headless corpse, still standing, twisted as its knees buckled, and a thin sigh escaped from the trachea as it folded to the floor.
"It doesn't!"
Agen Kolar swayed. His emerald blade shrank away, and the hand grip tumbled from his opening fingers. A small, neat hole in the back of his forehead leaked smoke, showing light from the back of his head.
Hurt.
He pitched forward onto his face and lay still. Palpatine stood at the doorway, but the door stayed shut. From his hand extended a blade the color of fire. The door locked itself at his back. Help! Help! Security! Someone! Help me! Murder! Treason! Then he smiled. He held one finger to his lips and, astonishingly, he winked. In the blank second that followed, while Mace Windu and Kit Fisto could do no more than angle their lightsabers to guard, Palpatine swiftly stepped over the bodies back towards his desk, reversed his blade, and drove it into a swift, surgical, precise stab down into his desktop. That's enough of that. He let it burn its way through the front. Then he turned. Lifting his weapon, appearing to study it as one might study the face of a beloved friend one has long thought dead. Power gathered around him until the force shimmered with darkness. If only you knew, he said softly, perhaps speaking to the Jedi Masters, or perhaps to himself, or perhaps even to the scarlet blade lifted now as though in mocking salute. How long I've been waiting for this. Anakin's speeder shrieked through the rain, dodging forked bolts of lightning that shot up from the towers into the clouds, slicing across traffic lanes, screaming past spacers so fast that his shockwave cracked windows as he passed. He didn't understand why people didn't just get out of his way. He didn't understand how the trillions of beings who jammed Galactic City could go about their trivial businesses as though the universe hadn't changed. How could they think they counted for anything compared with him? How could they think they still mattered? Their blind lives meant nothing now. None of them. Because ahead, on the vast cliff face of the Senate office building, one window spat lightning into the rain to echo the lightning of the storm outside. But this lightning was the color of clashing lightsabers. Green fans, sheets of purple, and crimson flame. He was too late. The green fire faded and winked out. Now the lightning was only purple and red. His repulsors howled as he heeled the speeder up onto its side, skidding through the wind shear turbulence to bring it to a bodying halt outside the window of Palpatine's private office. A blast of lightning hit the spire of 500 Republica only a kilometer away, and its white burst flared off the window, flash blinding him. He blinked furiously, slapping at his eyes in frustration. The colorless glare inside his eyes faded slowly, bringing into focus a jumble of bodies on the floor of Palpatine's private office. Bodies in Jedi robes. On Palpatine's desk lay the head of Kit Fisto, face up, scalp tentacles unbound in a squid tangle across the ebonite. His lidless eyes stared blindly at the ceiling. Anakin remembered him at the arena at Geonosis, effortlessly carving his way through wave after wave of combat droids. On his lips, a gently humorous smile, as though the horrific battle were only some friendly jest. His severed head wore that same smile. Maybe he thought death was funny too. Anakin's own blade sang blue as it slashed through the window and he dived through the gap. He rolled to his feet among a litter of bodies and sprinted through a shattered door along the small private corridor and through a doorway that flashed and flared with energy scatter. Anakin skidded to a stop. Within the public office of the Supreme Chancellor of the Galactic Republic, a last Jedi Master battled alone, blade to blade, against a living shadow.